So today we're going to show you how to do a simple horizontal laser shaft alignment using two shafts that are coupled together. So the reason we're going to do this is we get asked a lot, how difficult is it to use a laser shaft alignment unit? Our friends from Vibralign, this is Steve, they came over, they volunteered, and they're going to help us do this and show you just how easy it is.
Thanks, Matt. I'm going to show the operation of laser alignment equipment built by Fixturlaser. When you get the case and open it up, you'll see several components inside. First is the display unit. There are two sensors and receivers that we'll be attaching to the shafts. Tape measure. There are extra posts to add to the brackets. And there are magnetic attachments inside. And also chain extensions in case you're going around a shaft that's very large in diameter. This is the display unit with an on button, so we'll go ahead and turn that on. These are the various sensor units. One is marked S for the stationary side, and one is marked M for the movable side, typically the electric motor. So we're going to take the S sensor, which is for the stationary piece, which is typically a pump or a fan or something along those lines, and we're just going to attach the sensor to the shaft or the coupling half. Either way is fine. The M, as I said earlier, typically goes on the motor or the movable element. And again, we'll just quickly attach the sensors like so. So now what we need to do is to communicate the sensors with the display unit, and you'll see the on buttons at the top. We're just going to turn those on. And what you'll see is the blue lights blinking. When they go solid, they're communicating with the display unit. It's a wireless system. We have the sensors on the shafts, and we're at the main screen. File cabinet for saved data. Bluetooth is on. Battery indicator light. This is the shaft alignment program. We'll go ahead and touch on that. When I do that, the lasers will fire. There's a laser in this sensor firing to the detector here. There's a laser in this sensor here firing to the detector here. All we need to do is get the laser somewhere near the center of the detector. I do that by just loosening these clips on the back and putting the laser close to the center. Okay, the first thing that the display unit asks for is a set of dimensions so it can do the calculations. The first dimension that you see on screen is the distance between the two posts, and you measure center of the post to center of the post. In this case, it's 6.5 inches. So I'm going to load in 6.5 and hit the check mark. The second distance that it wants to know is from the center of the coupling to the movable sensor. And again, depending on if you're equidistant, in a lot of cases you're not, you just simply measure from the center of the coupling over, and it's 3.25. The third measurement is from the movable sensor to the inboard feet on the electric motor. This is so it can calculate shim corrections. We're just going to measure over from the chain, or you can roll the sensors over and measure from the end of the posts. And in this case, it's 3/4 of an inch. The third dimension is from foot to foot on the electric motor. And again, I'm just going to take my tape measure and measure center of the bolt to center of the bolt. In this case, it's 6 inches. The next thing that comes up on screen is a tolerance chart that shows the allowable angular and offset misalignment based on the machine RPM. We're going to assume that this is an 1800 RPM motor, so we're going to select the 1800 tolerance and hit the check mark. Now I'm ready to measure. Once we've selected the tolerance, it takes us to the measurement screen. You'll see on screen here that as I move these sensors around, the display on the screen changes as well and gives us the position of the two sensors. And you'll see the little triangle that's over at the 9 o'clock position. I want to rotate the sensor somewhere over near 9 o'clock in reference to take my first measurement. You'll see that this here, the measure key is up by the electric motor. I'm going to touch on the screen, and it's going to log the first measurement point. You'll notice that on the display unit, all those numbered values at the top of the screen are now zero, because that's the reference point. The S value is the raw data of the stationary sensor, and the M value is the values in the movable sensor. And those angle symbols on the outside, that's just the angle reference of where the two sensors are. You'll notice that there's been an area that's shaded out on the display unit in red, and you can see that it's asking the user to rotate the sensor somewhere near 12 o'clock. So I'm simply going to move the sensors up near 12 o'clock. It doesn't need to be exact, but just somewhere out of that red shaded area, and I'm going to hit the measure key again. Once it logs the measurement point, it asks the user to rotate the sensor somewhere near 3 o'clock. So we'll just simply rotate the sensors over to 3, again towards that green triangle, and we'll take our third measurement point. This is the result screen based on the tolerance that I selected. You'll see that these numbers are quite large. These numbers are in mils, so 45 is 45 thousandths, 1 is 1 thousandths. All the information you see up on top here is how the electric motor is sitting in relationship to the pump in the vertical plane, and all the numbers down here is how the electric motor is sitting in the horizontal plane. I've got some work to do. If I want to save the data, touch on the file cabinet. It automatically date and time stamps it. By touching on this white bar, you can call it whatever you want. And once you've named the file, hit the check mark, hit the check mark again. Alignment reports are saved as both .bmp files, which is a picture file, and also .txt files. Both files can be offloaded by plugging in the USB. The next thing that's highlighted is the shim icon, or the correction key, because we have work to do. We'll touch on that. It tells me that I have to add 41 thousandths to the inboard feet and 35 thousandths to the outboard feet to correct the misalignment condition. I've got my shims counted out, and I'm going to loosen the feet on the electric motor and add the shim packs. So once I've got the shims under all 4 feet, I need to correct it in the horizontal plane. Once I've added the shims to the electric motor, I'm going to take a look at it in the horizontal plane. I touch on the icon. For accuracy, making horizontal corrections, I'm going to want to adjust the lasers so they're in the horizontal plane. And you can see here that I have to move the electric motor in the direction of the arrows. After making the horizontal corrections, and my numbers are green within the tolerance, and I tighten the hold down bolts, I'm ready to remeasure. This is the remeasure key. I'll simply touch on that, confirm that I want to remeasure, and I'll go through the same measurement process I did before, measuring at 9, 3, and 12. After remeasuring, I've confirmed that the corrections I did make brought the electric motor and pump within the 1800 RPM tolerance. Now I can save the data, again by pushing on the file icon. And the alignment is complete.
So that was basic horizontal shaft alignment. We'd like to thank our friends from Vibralign for stopping by and showing that to us. If you have any interest in this or any other equipment, please log on to our site at www.atecorp.com or go ahead and give us a call. Thanks.